your lower classes, you learned about the equations. And how many types of equations you learned? You learned about linear equations, simultaneous equations, quadratic equations, cubic equations, and biquadratic equations, and how you will frame the equations with the word problems, how these equations will be helpful in your real life. These are all the things you learned. So now we are going to learn about the different types of equation. It is called a differential equations. Differential equations. Differential equations. What is the meaning of differential equation? Differential equation is the equation. It contains more than two terms. With differentiate with one variable with respect to the another variable. This is called a differential equation. That the meaning is dy by dx. What is the dy by dx? Here, x is the independent variable and y is the dependent variable. These kind of equations is called a differential equations. Dy by dx is nothing but y dash. So y1, y2, y3, or we will name it as y dash, y double dash, y triple dash. This is the first degree differential equation. This is the second degree differential equation. This is third degree differential equations. These are the type of differential equations. So we are going to see about how the differential equations, how to form a differential equation, what is the order and the degree of the differential equation. As I told, 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree equations. So we are going to see about the order and the degree of the differential equation and how to form a differential equation and how to check whether the given equation is the solution of the differential equation and how to solve different types of equations. We are going to see about these all the things. But our, according to our syllabus, they related these all the things. Form a differential equation is related portion for us. So we are going to see order and degree of the equations and how to check whether the given equation is the solution of the differential equation and various type of equation. How to solve various type of equation. First, I am going to see what is the order and the degree of the equation. What is the order? And we have learned in differential equations, what is the differentiation? What is the order? Dy by dx means it is the first order. D square by dx square, d square by dx square, this is nothing but y double dash, this is the second order. D cube y by dx cube, d cube y by dx cube, this is called third degree, third order differentiation. So, what is the order? Order is the highest derivatives. The equation contains the highest derivative. It is called the order of differential equation. For example, dy by dx plus 3y is equal to 0. This is the differential equation. Because it contains a variable, dy by dx. As I told, x is the independent variable, y is the dependent variable. So this is the differential equation. This is the first order differential equation because it is the highest derivative is the first order derivative. So this order will be 1. So order is the highest derivative of the given equations. So order is 1. Okay. Second equation. So this equations, the order of the differential equation is 1. Next equation, you see d square y by dx square plus 3 into dy by dx plus y is equal to 0. So as order of the differential equation, this is second order, this is the first order, which is the highest. Second order is the highest. So order of this differential equation is called 2. Okay, this is the order. Order means highest derivative of a given equation is called order. So then we will go to degree. What is the degree? Already you learned in the degree of quadratic equation. Quadratic equation means what is the degree? Degree is 2. Cubic equation degree is 3 because the highest power is called a degree. But here the differential equation, the highest, the power of highest derivative, if it is a polynomial function, then only it is called a, then only we can define the order, a degree. Otherwise, you can write only the order. See, look at this equation. See, now this question, here the order will be 1. What is the degree? I told degree is the power of highest derivative. Here the highest derivative is 1. So what is the power of this? This power, there is nothing, means power is 1. So here degree is 1. Degree is 1. Okay, can you tell about, say about this equation? Here, what is the order? It is the second order differential equation. Any doubt in the order and degree?
No, ma'am.
Any doubt, children?
No, ma'am.
Next, I will go to equation. Next, we are going to solve. We have learned how many types of equation there are, so first degree, second degree. Is there any types of differential equation? Many types of differential, ordinary differential, partial differential, homogeneous equation, non-homogeneous equations, linear differential equation. There are many types of equations are there. For our syllabus, we are going to learn only about the first order differential equation. First order differential equation, that is only with respect to dy by dx, first order differential equation. How to solve a first order differential equation? So here, so I will come to one by one method, how to solve it. There are three methods we are going to learn. Variable separable method. First method is called variable separable method. Variable separable means there will be two variables will be there. We have to separate two variables, then we have to integrate and put the solution. Second method is called homogeneous equations. Second method is called homogeneous equation. Third method is called linear equations. How to solve a linear equations? This is only a syllabus. So first order differential equation, different types of first order equations, how to solve. As we have solved in a quadratic equation, how many methods you know to solve a quadratic equations? As you learn in your 10th standard at all, quadratic equation we can solve in any method. Anybody has any idea? Quadratic equations using the formula, using factorization that you learned especially in the middle term is called the factorization method and the completing square method. Like this, a normal quadratic equation also having many methods. Okay, suppose you will see the term, you are able to factorize. Then you will factorize and solve. Suppose you are not able to factorize, you will use the formula or complete its method, any method. Like this, a differential equation also you have three methods. Suppose if you are not able to solve in this method, then you can go to this method. So each method is different. So first method is variable separable method. So in this method, see, look at one question, I am giving one example. Dy by dx is equal to 1 plus x square into 1 plus y square. First you see, we can separate this variable or not. First method is that. After looking at the question, you see we can separate all the y terms one side or the x term one side or not. If you are not able to do that, then you have to go to the next method. Always try with the first method. So here, these both terms are in multiplication. So you can bring this term here as a denominator. Dy by 1 plus x square is equal to 1 plus x square into dx. That's all. See, all the y term is one side, all the x term is one side. Now you have to integrate. So dy by 1 plus y square. All we learned in integration. What is this? Dy divided by 1 plus y square is nothing but tan inverse of y is equal to. Here, 1 plus x square into 2x. How to integrate this term? 1 into dx plus integration of x square into dx. So the answer will be 1 into dx is x and x square into dx is x cube by 3 plus c. So tan inverse of y is equal to x plus x cube by 3 plus c. This is the solution of this equation. So the question will be solved. Solve this question. So we can see which method we can use. So this method is called variable separable method. Solve the differential equation in the homogeneous method. Before going to solve, so many students has confusion about what this equation can I separate, can I do it in a variable separable method? Why can't I do it? Because x, y and x, I can split x and y separately. So what you will do is, first check whether the given equation is homogeneous or not. After checking, you can do the same method. So first I will let you know how to prove given equation is a homogeneous or not. So let this term is f of x, y, right, is equal to x plus y by x. So what I will do is, I will replace x and y by lambda x, lambda y. It is nothing but x is lambda x, y is lambda y divided by lambda x. Now look at this, lambda is common in both the terms, x plus y y by x, we have taken as f of x, y. So f of lambda x, lambda y, you can able to write lambda power 0 into f of x, y. Then the given equation is a homogeneous equation. Now you can solve this homogeneous equation. How to solve? So here we are going to introduce your new variable because x and y we are not able to separate, right? So we are going to introduce one new variable here. Okay, first write this d1 by dx equation, but now I am going to introduce one new variable. Y is equal to vx. Y is equal to vx because the given equation is not able to separate. So I am going to introduce one new variable. Y is equal to vx. I am going to convert the given equation in terms of v and x. After that, v and x I am going to separate it. After separating v and x, we will use the first method as variable separable. Okay, here v is not a constant, v is variable. So this I am going to differentiate. V by dx is equal to this. You have to do it in u. V into x differentiation is 1. Now x into v between dv by dx, as I told, v is not a constant, v is a variable. This is equation number 2. Now look at the equation. This also dy by dx. This also dy by dx. So can I equate equation 1 and 2? So x plus y divided by x is equal to v plus x into dv by dx. Replace all of y as dx, dx. So x plus dx divided by x minus v is equal to x into dv by dx. Just by simplifying all the v and x term on side. So x plus vx minus vx 4 divided by x is equal to x into dv by dx. So vx dx will be cancelled. X and x also got cancelled. 1. Now this x by dx, you bring it to this side, it will be dx by x is equal to dv. So now you see x and v is separated. So now you can use the first method. Dx by x, what is the answer? Log x. And the dv, integration of dv will be d plus c. After integration, you have to add one constant b plus c. Now, we have to convert this d. Log x is equal to b is nothing but y by x because b is equal to y x plus c. This is the solution of the given equations in solved by homogeneous method. So, homogeneous method, now you can, if you have doubt whether the given equation I can do whether variable separable or homogeneous, you can check with this given method and you can solve. Linear equation. How to solve a linear equation? Suppose an equation cannot be solved by variable separable or homogeneous, we are going to learn this method. This equation will be always in the form either dy by dx plus dy is equal to q or dx by dy plus px is equal to q. Here the y will be the coefficient of p, here the x will be the coefficient of p. P is the coefficient of x, here p is the coefficient of y. Okay. So here I will give one example. Suppose this is the question, cos square x into dy by dx plus y is equal to tan x. See, look at this equation. Whether this equation can be solved using a variable separable? Can you separate the variable x and y? It's impossible, right? Okay. Then can I use the homogeneous? I told you how to find out whether the given equation is a homogeneous or not. The equation should be in the form of f of lambda x comma lambda y is equal to lambda power 0 of f of x comma y. Why lambda power 0? Because you are learning only the first degree differential equation, that's why. So this is definitely not a homogeneous. Definitely we are not able to solve, right? Variable separable. Okay, now this is linear, this method. So you can ask me the question, now linear equation I have told you either dy by dx plus py is equal to q. But here cos square x into dy by dx. So what I will do? I will divide each term by cos square x. Now you do dy by dx plus y divided by cos square x is equal to tan x divided by cos square x. Can you write like this? Because we can divide the entire term by cos square x. Now you look at this term. This is in the form of this, right? Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. What is p? I told you the coefficient of y. So what is the coefficient of y here? 1 by cos square x. So p is equal to Maybe the population growth. Suppose 2022 our population